All right, so working on the 2011 Ford Fiesta again today. So with the transmission refixed, the TCM replaced, there is only one code that's still active, and it's an engine code, and it is P0054, which is it's an O2 sensor, heater, resistance, bank 1, sensor 2, which I believe bank 1 refers to which side of the engine it is on, but it's a four-cylinder, so there's only one side. And sensor 2 means it is the one behind the catalytic converter. So it could be a problem with the wiring. It could be a problem with the fuse. It could be a problem with the O2 sensor. More than likely, it's going to be the O2 sensor. I did check the fuse. It was fuse 17 in the underhood fuse box. I checked that fuse. It was fine. So it talks about the heated exhaust gas oxygen sensor, and it is fuse 17. It's a 15 amp fuse. So I'm looking at the picture, you can see F17 is right there. So it is the 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. It is the sixth fuse down in that left-hand row of blade fuses. Okay, so if we remove this cover, we get to this fuse box here. And here are your two rows of blade fuses. It is the sixth one down on the left side. So if you have a small enough probe, there's actually two little ports where you can touch them and make sure that you have continuity on the fuse. I don't have one that is quite small enough, so I'm going to pull it. Boom. So, you can do a visual inspection by holding it up to the light and make sure that the loop is there. Or I'm going to set my multimeter to continuity check. So that's like there. Okay, so now it's going to test and see. So when you touch these together, it beeps so that you know that you have continuity. And so as long as the fuse isn't blown, it should beep. So I'm gonna attach that to one side. There. So now that's how you can tell that the fuse is not blown. So there are two, like I said, two little ports up here. If the tips on your probes are small enough, you can get in there and test that without having to pull it. So, and there is a map on the lid that tells you where all the fuses are. Okay. So looking up underneath the car, so the plug for the sensor is right here, and the sensor is right up here, plugged into the exhaust right behind the catalytic converter. You need a 7/8 inch wrench to remove it. Let's dig in. All right, so let's see if we can get this plug out. So I'm just gonna pop this little standoff out of the way. So you might have something that clips on to this metal bracket. So you just press down the tab that's behind it. And you pry it loose. So if you can't pull it, you know, you might be able to get a little screwdriver in here and pry it up while you're holding that tab down. There it goes. And now I got that plug out. Okay, yeah, so here's that tab. You just needed to press down here. And then I had to use a little effort to pry it loose. So now I'm going to try and loosen the sensor. So I've got a 7/8 inch wrench. Let's see if the open end side of it will loosen it. Did that move? Or did it? I think it did. Now I'm in a situation where I can't get the wrench back on. Got a different wrench. Is it at the same angle or at a different angle? Mm-hmm. Okay, now the light's in the way. All right, let's see. Let's see, will it loosen my hand now? I don't have a sensor socket, so I'm just gonna try and do the best I can with this. With my wrenches here. There we go. But it doesn't really feel like it should, just... There we go, I can move it by hand, that's good. Alright, this is the part. It's a Ford Motorcraft DY1152. So that's the replacement part. As you can see, it has the matching purple plug. So either this wire coating was yellow, I think it was yellow, I was gonna say, or may possibly it faded over time, but that looks like the right one to me. So it is all gunked up and junky in here because they coat it with anti-seize. So I'm gonna, since it looks like a lot of it has worn off, I'm just gonna put a new small coating of anti-seize on there. All right, so there's the sensor, and I'm just gonna put a little bit of anti-seize on here, just like that. All right, and I just used a towel to spread it around a little bit. Now let's get it back in. Tight. All right, so the sensor should probably be torqued down around 26 to 33 foot-pounds, but I do not have a torque wrench that I can put on here, so I am going to do the best that I can, just kind of make them good and tight. We're gonna go with that, and then we need to plug this back in, but I'm gonna put this clip back on here first. Right. Okay, and now we should be able to plug it in. There, it's clipped back in, and well, this has a shorter wire, so it doesn't actually really need that to hold it. It doesn't feel like it would, feel like putting it over here would put some pressure on it, but yeah. So I don't think I need that. I'm gonna leave that alone. Okay, so I'm gonna take it out for a ride and see if the check engine light goes away. I'd rather not clear it and then wait for it to come back. I wanna see if it clears itself. Okay, so it's actually a few days later. I took it out for a ride that night. I drove about 20 miles. The light stayed on. I didn't feel like wasting any more gas just driving around. So I just used it for the next few days, driving on just some short trips here and there. So eventually I racked up about 50 miles and then the light did turn off. So for the first time since I've owned this, the check engine light is not on. So we're in good shape with that. So now I just need to make an appointment to get it inspected. Okay, so if you got something out of this video about how to change the O2 sensor in your Ford Fiesta, please be sure to give it a thumbs up. And if you want to help this channel out, please consider subscribing or becoming a member by clicking the join button below. Thanks for watching. Take care.